everyone. Today in this video I am going to discuss with you an example on the Djikstra's algorithm for finding shortest path between two vertices and the length of that path. Now for showing you the example, first we need a graph. So let's draw the graph first. Now let's label the vertices. So this is V1, this is V2, V3, V4, V5, V6, and this is V7. Okay, now let's give the weights to the edges. So this is 12, this is 8, 2, 4, this is 3, this is 7, this is 5, this is 1, this is 7, this is 3, 2, 3, 4, 7, 2, and this one is 10, this one is 3. Okay, so now let's start. Now, before proceeding with the algorithm, the first step that we need to follow is that we need to eliminate the parallel edges based on their weights. Okay, so the edge having the smallest weight will be retained and the others will be eliminated. Okay, so let's consider this edge between V1 and V6. There are three edges. Among them, this edge, this one, has the smallest weight, that is 3. So what we will do? We will eliminate the other two. So let's do it. So this one is the edge between V1 and V6. The rest two have been eliminated. Now let's do the same for edge between V3 and V4. Since this is the edge with the smallest weight, therefore this edge must be eliminated. So let's do that. Okay. Now, this one is a self loop. So we will eliminate this one also. Okay, now you can see no more self loops or parallel edges are there between any two vertices. Okay, now we can proceed with the algorithm without any problem. So first, what we have to do, we have to consider the starting point, that is the starting vertex and the destination vertex. So here we will consider V2 as the starting vertex and V5 as the destination vertex. Okay, so what we will do, we need to find the shortest path between V2 and V5 and also the length of that path, right? So let's start. Now for that we need to make a table first. So V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6, V7. V4, V5, V6, V7. Okay? Okay. Since we are starting from V2, therefore, at first we need to consider all the vertices except V2 as infinity. Okay? So what we will do? We will write infinity in all of these columns except for V2, because in V2 we will write 0. Okay? So, since this one is the minimum among all these columns, therefore we will mark it and we will put a tick mark against it to label it. Okay, now why we are labeling it, that we will get to know at the end. Now, so the first row is complete. Now, since V2 is the minimum in the previous row, therefore in the second row what we will do, we will consider the connections between V2 and other vertices. If any vertex is directly connected to V2, then in that case we will write the edge weight and compare it with the previous value. Okay, let's see how it's done. Now, since V2 is connected to V1, therefore we will write here minimum and bracket we will compare it with the previous value, that is infinity, and the current value, that is the previous minimum plus the weight. So 0 plus 1. Now minimum between these two is 1. Okay, so we will keep it like that until we consider all the other values, and then we will see which one is the minimum among all the values. So in case of V2, now keep one thing in mind. If we have marked one value as the minimum, then it will remain as that minimum value, that is, it will remain same for the rest of the rows. Okay? So it will continue to be as 0. Now V3, we can see that V2 is directly connected to V3 via a edge, and that has weight 7. So we will write here minimum, then in bracket first the previous value, that is infinity, then the previous minimum, that is 0, plus the edge weight, that is 7. So that is equal to 7. Okay. Now V4 is not directly connected to V2, so it will remain the same as infinity. Similar is the case with V5, so again it's also infinity. V6 also infinity, because it's not directly connected to V2, and V7 is also not directly connected, so it will remain as infinity. Now among all these values we can see that 1 is minimum, so we will mark it and label it. So now the current minimum is 1. Okay, so we will use 1 as the current minimum in the next row. Okay, so now the current minimum is 1 and it has come under V1. So now we will consider the direct connections from V1. So this will remain same as the minimum, this will also remain same as 0. Now V3, we can see that V3 is directly connected to V1 and the edge weight is 3. So it will be written as minimum, previous value is 7, then previous minimum is 1 plus the current weight is 3. So that will be equal to 4. Now V4 is not directly connected to V1, so we will mark it as infinity. Then V5 is directly connected to V1, no, again infinity. V6, yes, V6 is connected to V1, So we will write here minimum, then it will be 7, and it's the previous minimum, the previous value was infinity, so infinity, then previous minimum was 1 plus the weight is 3, so that's equals to 4, and V7 is also connected to V1, so that will be minimum infinity 1 plus weight is 4, so 4, that will be equal to 5. So we can see that this and this both are equal to 4. We can consider any one of them, but since we are going in this way and then checking for the minimum from this side, so we will consider this one as the minimum as it comes first from this side. So we will label it like this. So the current minimum is 4 and it comes for V6. Okay, so in the next row we will consider the connections, direct connections for V6. Okay, so we are completed with this row. Okay, now for the next row, for the next row we will keep it as it was 1 0. Now V3, now V3 is not directly connected to V6, so what we will do, we will write here minimum, since the previous minimum was 4 for this one, and then what we will do, we will write here infinity, okay, because currently it's not connected directly, so that will be equal to 4. Okay, and this is V4. Now V4 is not directly connected. Yes, it's directly connected via this edge. So it will be written as minimum infinity comma, the previous minimum was 4 plus 10. Okay, that is equal to 14. Right? Now we have V5. So minimum infinity, since V5 is directly connected to V6, so minimum infinity comma 4 plus 7, that's equals to 11. Okay, and since it's already labeled, so we will write here 4, and finally we have minimum 5, then we have 4 plus 4, that's equals to 5 again, right? So this is the, this was the minimum, so this will be the minimum one among all, so we will mark it here, and with this ends our fourth row, right? So this was our fourth row. Now let's start with the fifth row. So next we have V1 already marked, V2 already marked, V3 already marked, and V6 already marked. Okay, and our current minimum is V3, right? So V3 is directly connected to V4, so what we will write, minimum, the previous value for V4 was 14. So 14, the current minimum is 4 and the weight is 8. So that means 12. Then we have V5. Now V3 is directly connected to V5? No. So what we will do, we will write here minimum. Then the previous value of V5 was 11. Then 4, the current minimum, plus infinity since it's not connected. That will be equal to 11. Now V7 is directly connected to V3, so we will write here minimum, the previous value was 5, so 5, the current minimum is 4 and the weight is 2, so 4 plus 2, that's equals to 5. Now as you can see, the minimum here is 5, so labeled it. So this was our fifth row. Now let's check for the sixth row. Now the current minimum is V7, so we will check for the direct connections from V7. Now since V1 already marked, V2 already marked, V3 already marked, V6 already marked, and V7 just marked. So now V4 from V7. Yes, there is a direct edge connection which has weight 3. So minimum 12, current minimum is 5 plus 3. That's 8. V5 also has direct connection which has edge weights 2. So minimum previous value 11, current minimum 5 plus 2, that's 7. Now the minimum currently here is 7 and we will label it. Now what we will do, we will stop here. Why we will stop here? Because our destination vertex, that is V5, has been labeled. Okay? Now, since it has been labeled, therefore, that means we have reached our destination. Now, what we need to find is the length of the path, that is the shortest path between our source vertex and the destination vertex. Now, since our destination vertex has been marked minimum with the value of 7, therefore our shortest path distance is equal to 7 units. So this is our path length, shortest path length, that is 7. The value for which our destination vertex will be marked minimum, that will be the length of the shortest path. Okay, now how we will find the shortest distance, or rather the shortest path, that is which vertices it will cover to go from V2 to V5, and that will cover the shortest distance. So how we will find that? Let's find out. But for that I have to rub this one and I have to draw the whole table again. So let's do it. Okay guys, so this is the whole table. Now I will show you how to find out the shortest path between V2 and V5. Okay, now since the last marked minimum is V5, so we will consider it first. So V5. Now we will backtrace. Okay, we will backtrace and go and find out where the value of V5 has last changed. And we can see that it has changed here. Okay. Now in this row the minimum was V7, so we will write here V7. Now we will consider V7 and backtrace it and go and find out in which row its value was last changed, and we can see that it has changed here. And in this row the minimum was V1, so we will write here V1. Then we will consider V1 and backtrace and find out where its value was last changed, and we can see that it was changed here where the minimum was V2, so we will write here. So this is our shortest path starting with V2 and ending at V5. Okay, so this was how you can find out the shortest path and the shortest distance between two given vertices using the Djikstra's algorithm. So that was all for this video. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to my channel for upcoming videos. Subscribe to it if you haven't yet, and press the bell icon to get notified whenever I upload any future content. Thank you.